Lady, first it was potassium iodide tablets, and now another product is flying off store shelves as some area people look to protect themselves from Japan's radiation using seaweed.
No, I don't usually take kelp.
But now Mark Sanders plans on taking a lot of it, buying more than $100 worth of dried seaweed at a health food store in Roseville.
Well, it's got iodine in it that can protect your thyroid because of the radiation fallout that's hitting Sacramento right now as we speak.
For some, it appears seaweed is the new radiation comfort food.
Say yesterday we sold about $1,000 worth of seaweed.
Wow, that's pretty
amazing. A lot of seaweed.
Don't worry. Don't panic.
KCRA3 health expert Dr. Tom Hopkins says whether it's in seaweed or a pill, you just don't need that extra iodide.
Don't get caught up in thinking that potassium iodide tablets are going to do anything to protect you when you're so far removed from any source of any radiation.
32 in San Francisco, it's pretty high.
Sanders is following the information he's getting, and for now, he'll continue to follow his gut.
I'd stock up on food and water for at least 6 months because it's going to go through the roof, and, you know, their crops and animals and everything are going to be, you know, affected by the radiation fallout.
So you can tell he's worried. How concerned should you really be about radiation in California right now? Joining us live tonight to kind of help us sort through this, radiation biologist Dr. Marvin Goldman from UC Davis. Doctor, thanks for being here.
Thank you.
First of all, as you just watched that man in our piece, and obviously he's genuinely concerned. Are his worries unfounded?
I think they are very unfounded. I think it's rather unfortunate that people have been so terrorized that they're running around buying kelp and potassium iodide to block their thyroid glands for doses that aren't here and are not likely to ever be here. Right. The reason I'm saying that is because even if there is a much larger release of radioactivity from the sites in Japan, they've got 6,000 miles across the Pacific to go. During that time, a lot of the radioactivity will decay, and a lot of it's going to be so diluted and so dispersed that even though we might be able to measure a few atoms, it's certainly not going to be any kind of a radiation dose of any concern whatsoever. Thousands and maybe millions of times lower than anything of concern. So I think it's rather ill-advised for people to be running around being hysterical about this.
Yeah. Well, going back 25 years ago, you studied the Chernobyl disaster that happened in the Soviet Union at the time. And knowing what you know about that and the fallout and all of that, compare that to what we've seen here at this Fukushima plant in Japan.
Well, they're two totally different kinds of accidents. In the case of Chernobyl, the reactor was not in a containment vessel and literally blew up, putting a large amount of radioactivity in the air. And many miles downwind, the radioiodine and radiocesium caused some radiation doses, but the other particulates dropped down really close and didn't go further. So the problem in Russia at that time was that there was not adequate warning of the population not to drink the fresh milk that contained the radioiodine that had dropped onto the newly grown grass. And even that would have prevented a large amount of thyroid radiation.
Even that.
And the other important thing is that the dose that you could possibly get from inhalation of these materials is very, very small. It's the ingestion dose from contaminated foods that's important to worry about. But that was in the Ukraine, and that's not at all the case here. Here we have some release of radioiodine, which is volatilized out of the damaged pools and some of the damaged reactor core. And we have a small amount of radioactivity released. You have a large field of radiation around the reactors
right now,
but I don't have any measurements, nor does anybody else that I know of have any. So I can't tell you how bad it is or whether it's getting worse or getting better.
Yeah, but I think the takeaway from this is that your analysis and your words seem to be comforting. So I think at this point, it sounds like there's really no worry out there. No need to buy this stuff.
No,
right
I certainly wouldn't
All right.
buy that. Yes.
Dr. Marvin Goldman from UC Davis, thanks for talking with us today. Appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.
All right. Now, we do have a question here on our web poll. Check it out. How concerned are you about nuclear radiation coming to California from Japan? Very concerned, somewhat concerned, or not concerned at all? Go ahead and log on to KCRA.com. We would love to hear your response.